Hello， 大家好，欢迎来到丰臣秀吉，我是 Yoshi。 今天呢，我看到 Dr. Rubini 这位所谓的末日博士呢所发表的一篇文章，然后呢其中有讲到呢美国的金融市场、房地产还有所谓的 cryptocurrency 的市场呢都正在处于一个泡沫的情况，那他就警惕大众说大家要小心，因为这个泡沫随时都有可能会破灭。那他其中呢还把 Bitcoin 点名出来，指明说他觉得 Bitcoin 呢是没有任何存在的价值的。他说股票呢是代表了公司的一个 value， 黄金呢是可以拿来做 store of value， 那也可以拿来抵抗通膨，然后房地产的话呢大家可以住在里面或是可以当投资用收租金。他不认为 Bitcoin 可以拿来干嘛，不能拿来装饰，不能拿来做运用，什么都不可以。对他而言，他觉得 Bitcoin 就是一群人在那边炒作的一个话题而已。刚好他上个礼拜呢也有跟雅虎 Finance 呢做了一个 interview， 那我们就来听听看这位伟大的末日博士呢在雅虎 Finance 里面聊到 Bitcoin 的时候呢，他对 Bitcoin 的说法是什么。
We know there are pump and dump schemes, there are wash trading, spoofing, there is front running even by exchanges, and there is this phenomenon of Tether, stable coin that is produced out of nowhere. We don't know which kind of backing. And every other day, there's $1 billion of it issued that goes to buying Bitcoin. So then there's massive price manipulation. There are a bunch of whales and insiders that are manipulating this market. And we know there are a whole bunch of legal investigation by the DOJ, by the CFTC, by the Attorney General Office in New York that are looking into what's going on. So I think it's a very risky asset class.
所以在他第一个 section 的这个 interview 里面呢，他有讲到所谓的 Tether 这个 stable coin 呢一直在那边印钱。其实他讲的这个部分呢我也是认同的，那这也就是为什么我之前的一个 video 里面呢有讲到说，我觉得 Bitcoin 呢在5月中之前呢可能会有一个比较大的 correction， 主要就是因为呢在5月15号的时候呢 Tether 跟 Bitfinex 他们这个公司呢需要提供给 New York AG 他们到底有没有1:1的 cash reserve 在 back out 他们的 Tether stablecoin， 如果没有的话整个 Tether 公司就会有出很大的问题，因为 Tether stablecoin 呢跟很多 cryptocurrency 呢是息息相关紧紧相连的，所以呢如果 Tether 一出状况呢，肯定整个 cryptocurrency 或是 Bitcoin 的价钱呢绝对会大受影响。那在这个部分的话，我觉得他的 concern 我也是支持的。 Bitcoin 呢在目前来讲它是有一个风险存在，因为它跟所谓的 Tether 连接性是非常高的，我觉得这个 Bitcoin 价钱的 correction 呢是无可避免的。那我们再来听一下他下一段的 interview 吧。
Nouriel, it's truly LaRoche, and you're mentioning some of the whales who are in the space, and you believe it's a risky asset class, and I think the last time we did speak you said that look thisThing has no place in an institutional investor's portfolio or a retail investor's portfolio yet. We've seen a lot of retail investors in the space. We have seen a lot of big names, very well-established names, enter the space. So, like, why not? Why not have just even just the tiniest little percentage allocation in Bitcoin? What is the argument against just having some exposure?
Well, there are some people that are risking their entire house on it. I mean, if you take Tesla, if you exclude the credits they get for gas emissions,is still a money-losing firm, and now they're betting all their entire cash on Bitcoin. If you want to become a Bitcoin fund, be a Bitcoin fund, but not an electric vehicle company. Or MicroStrategy is a tech firm that was flat for 10 years, didn't go anywhere, pretty much, and now the CEO is betting the entire cash and borrowing a $600 billion on Bitcoin. So you're not a technology company. There are people who are doing lots of risky stuff. You know, the people are institutions,Everybody wants to trade the stuff. Everybody wants to be custodial because regardless of whether it's worth zero or 50, they want to make money out of the trading. It's not as if Goldman Sachs or the custodians believe in this asset class. If you can get a cut out of the exchanges in the crypto space, so be it. And, you know, institutions are weird. You know, Scott Minard from Guggenheim Partners one day says, we're going into Bitcoin because it's going to go to 400,000. And the next month he says, no.It's going to go down to 20,000. Just make up your mind. The reality is that nobody knows what the value of this pseudo asset is. It doesn't have any value because it doesn't have any income, doesn't have any use, doesn't have any utility. So it's a total speculative play on a bubble that is self-fulfilling. And now we have, like in 2017, hundreds of thousands of retail suckers that are having FOMO, fear of missing out, going to this asset class. And they're going to buy at the peak like it happened in December of 2017 when Bitcoin was 20,000 and fell to 3,000 by the end of the next year. So it's the same phenomenon,
Muriel.
Just people moving in because of FOMO, feeding the bubble, manipulation, and eventually they get crushed. I mean, overnight,
well, we also,
12%, which asset class has that volatility?
Let me just keep this simple, because a lot of us, we get moved by the big sway. Fortunately, I don't have $50,000 to buy a Bitcoin, so I'm not at risk, but you could do a fractional, you know, you can buy a fraction of it. Is there any purpose for Bitcoin? I hear you dismissing it, but I think I'm missing something.
Well, an asset, usually stocks, bonds, loans, real estate, they give you income, and therefore there's a reason for the capital gain. If the dividends are not fully rebated, the profits. Other asset classes like real estate, residential, gives you housing services. You know, gold doesn't have income, but has uses in industry, has utility, has jewelry, and has been used for liquidity purposes and as a store of value for thousands of years. So you're asking yourself, what is the fundamental value of Bitcoin? Doesn't have any income, doesn't have any uses in industry, doesn't have any utility. You cannot have a gold chain of Bitcoin, doesn't give you any pleasure, unlike gold and jewelry and other stuff. And therefore, doesn't have any intrinsic fundamental value because it's not even scalable. You can do only 5 transactions per second with Bitcoin, while you can make 24,000 transactions per second with the Visa network. So it's never going to be able to be even a means of payment. And it's not a unit of account. It's not a single numerator. So people say it's a store of value against tail risk. But when in February, March of last year, U.S. stocks went down, say, 35%, Bitcoin was not a hedge. It went down by 50%. Another cryptocurrency went down by 60%. And if it's a hedge against inflation, what's the fundamental value that needs it to be a hedge against inflation? And if people are so worried about inflation, why Bitcoin goes from 5,000 to 50,000 while gold has been correcting downwards and break-evens are barely above 2% and tips are giving you returns are still relatively mediocre. If people were really worried about inflation, they would diversify in a wide range of assets that are historical good hedges against inflation. That's not happening. So that might not be the reason why Bitcoin is going higher. So it must be manipulation. There's nothing else that explains this movement.
OK, 所以在第二段的这个 interview 里面呢，他有讲到说，觉得这些所谓的 high tech 公司呢，他们投资 Bitcoin 呢，他们就是想要从中间赚钱，不，并不是真正看好 Bitcoin 这个东西的。在这个论点上面呢，我觉得就是你要看你从什么角度来去做出发点，因为这是一个自由的市场，所以很多人他们就会想要去从中间操作赚取利润。我觉得这个 Rubini 呢，他看到的都是一些比较在像是在大众一些主流新闻上面看到的一些东西，他没有真正的去看我们 crypto space 里面的一些 community 里面发出来的新闻。像他如果去 Bitcoin community 看一些 Bitcoin community engineer 或是这些 developer 他们发出来的一些新闻，肯定是不一样的。那当然我必须承认，大家今天投资一个 asset 的时候，肯定都是希望你投资的这个 asset 能赚钱。其实我觉得这个就很像你投资一个股票嘛，在投资一个股票的情况下，有些人绝对是看长远的，有些人是看中长期的，有些人是短线操作的嘛。不管你在怎么样的投资里面，它都会有所谓的短期、中期跟长期的所谓的投资者，所以就是看你从什么层面来去看这些投资者。你不能说短期操作这些投资者他们就是有问题，所以我觉得他在 criticize 这些 investor， 然后拿去做一个 criticize 整个 Bitcoin 或者是 cryptocurrency 的 industry 的一个说辞来讲的话，这个部分我是非常非常不能接受的。然后呢，他再来就讲说，他觉得 Bitcoin 是一个完全没有价值的东西。他说这个东西完全是基于个人的 perception， 基于一个个人的对这个价值的一个认知而已。这个部分呢，我就要请教一下鼎鼎大名的卢比尼先生，请问现在市场上哪一个东西的价值不是一个大众的 perception， 不是大众认定的一个价值的东西，而它有价值的？我们简单来讲好了，请问一下，现在的美金的价值是谁来定义的？现在的美金的价值是各个国家给它去定一个 value 以后，它就出来的价值。当初你在设定的这个价值的时候，请问它是有一个 formula 吗？它也不是嘛。它当初美金怎么去定价，这个黄金怎么去定价，这些其实都是一个大众的普世的一个价值， 来去定义这个东西它到底有多少 value 的。所以呢，我觉得他讲到有关 Bitcoin 这个价值只是大家给他的一个价值的话，任何东西到现在普遍大众如果认定它有这个价值的话，这个东西它就会有这个价值。其实平常讲这个 Bitcoin 它的价值在哪里没有人会知道，可是呢它的价值就建立于说今天大家觉得它值多少钱它就应该是值多少钱。然后后来他又讲到说这个 Bitcoin 呢根本没有什么作用，它也没有什么 utility 的 use， 它也没有办法创造任何 income。在这个部分的话，我们就可以了解到他就是从来没有真正接触或从来没有真正的深入研究 Bitcoin。 如果他真正知道 Bitcoin 的作用的话，就知道说他讲的这个 statement 完全是错误的。为什么？因为如果你有在操作所谓的 DeFi 的 project 的话，你就知道说其实你可以典当你的 Bitcoin 然后拿来去借钱。而且在新闻上我们也有看到实例，就是有人用 Bitcoin 去典当借钱而买到房子的。那当然以目前的操作来讲的话是有点复杂，可是呢他是真的借到钱买到房子的。所以表示什么？ Bitcoin 他在 DeFi 这个 industry 至少现在来说他是有实用的效应的，所以他所谓的 Bitcoin 完全没有用处的话，这个 statement 是完全已经错误的。那会讲出这种 Bitcoin 完全没有效用的这种，或是没有用处，或是没有任何 income 的价值来讲的这种人的话呢，他就是从来没有真正去了解 Bitcoin， 然后就直接 criticize Bitcoin 或是 criticize 整个 cryptocurrency 这个 industry 的人。到这个部分呢，就我对他这个人的了解，我觉得他可能是一个非常成功的一个我们所谓的经济学家或是一个教授，他可能所谓的经济学或是金融学里面呢他是非常非常厉害。可是呢在讲到这个 Bitcoin 或是 cryptocurrency 或是 blockchain technology 呢，我觉得他并没有花时间真正的去研究到底 Bitcoin 是以什么样的架构在存在，到底它的实用性质是如何。我个人觉得 Bitcoin 呢长期来讲的话，它的整个 value 一定是往上走的。那我们今天就先聊到这咯。如果喜欢我 content 的朋友呢，麻烦帮我按赞、订阅、分享、开启你的小铃铛。那如果对我的 content 有任何 comment 的朋友呢，请麻烦帮我留言哦。那我们就下次再见咯，拜拜。